New to iFIX? Installing iFIX for the first time? Hi, I'm Kathleen McKenna. I'm an information developer here at GE Digital, and I'm going to walk you through the installation process. iFIX is a high-performance HMI SCADA software product with a 35-year legacy in managing, controlling, and visualizing your industrial data. iFIX is supported on the following Windows operating systems. In this video, we're going to be installing iFIX on Windows Server 2019. For more information on the other system requirements, refer to the IPI. You can find this information on our documentation homepage, www.ge.com/digital/documentation. So click iFIX and then important product information, which is the IPI, and then system requirements. Before we begin, you're going to need to do a few things. First, log on to your computer as an administrator. Confirm that you aren't logged in via RDP or terminal server session. And then make sure there are no other GE processes running. There are four steps to install iFIX. Number one is run the product install. Number two, get the latest updates from the support website. Number three, for security purposes, change the default usernames and passwords for iFIX. And number four, optionally update the host file if you're required to do so. Now let's get started. Run the product install. So you're going to click the Install iFIX 6.1 link and then click Yes. Next, a few prereqs will install. A message box appears if a terminal server remote admin is detected. Just click OK to continue. On the welcome screen, click Next. When the license agreement appears, read through the terms and then click the Accept box to continue, and then Next. Select the type of iFIX install. I'm going to select Typical and then click Next. So right here, you're just going to leave the default path and then click Next. And then finally, click Install. So several screens will appear as the install progresses. So just hang out here for a little bit. Also, you're going to notice some additional options that get installed, such as common licensing. Some of the key features that you're going to get from iFIX 6.1 include the OPC UA client driver, a new web-based OPC UA client configuration tool, common historian server configuration, iFIX for IoT, alarm limit support for high-performance dynamos, and you'll see we're getting close to the end here. Now in this dialog, I'm going to select SCADA and Standalone, and then click OK. You can later change these in the SCU after the install completes, so don't worry too much if you make a mistake here. Click Yes to allow iFIX through the firewall, and at the end, choose whether to read the release notes and then reboot your computer. Now for step two, after you restart your computer, go up to the support website and check for any updates. So on digitalsupport.ge.com, you want to go to the iFIX product download page, right here, and then you'll see what updates are available. For more information about the support services and our acceleration plans, see www.ge.com/digital/services/support-services. For step three, for security purposes, it's really important that you go in and change those default usernames and passwords. So in the iFIX workspace, on the Applications tab, click Security, and then Security Configuration Utility. Click OK, as this is what we're going to fix. Next, click the Users button. Click the Guest User and then Modify. This opens the User Profile dialog box. Change the default usernames and passwords here, and then click OK. Next, click the System Administrator User, and then Modify, and then do the same thing. And then click OK to finish. Then you could save and exit the app. Now as your fourth and final step, if iFIX is not on a domain, you probably need to update the Windows host file. So this file assists Windows in resolving the host names or their IP addresses. So this isn't a step that everybody has to do. It really depends upon your setup. So from Windows Explorer, you could find the host file in the Windows System32/driver/etc folder. And you're just going to add the IP address and the computer name here, like this, and save the file. This concludes our walkthrough. Be sure to activate your licensing before using the product. Thank you for watching.